I'll start with the obvious question that I'm sure you're going to be asked all the time. Was this always going to be a Conjuring film?
You know, through development, it was always written with Father Perez in it, and always written with the tie-in with... is this a spoiler? Is this a post?
I'll do it as the movie comes out.
Great. So part of it, you know, with that is that, you know, we definitely wanted the spirit of discovery in the film. We wanted audiences to kind of come to that on their own. You know, there was a lot of discussion of should it be marketed as a Conjuring film, or should that be a fun surprise that people discover? And I love the way it plays out. I think that it's really fun. I mean, I think we kind of tip the hand by, you know, you see Father Perez in in the trailers. But I think everyone's kind of like a little bit on the fence. And some people think he died in Annabelle, which he didn't. You gotta rewatch the first one. He's still alive in the end.
I haven't seen it since theater, so.
Yeah, he's still alive in the end. There's a little bit of a debate question, and, you know, we just had to, like, really get James's blessing. And I think he was just so excited about the script that he really wanted it to be part of the universe. And then definitely as it got going, you know, that was something that, I mean, it has the spirit of the Conjuring universe, and I think that those movies are, you know, they are, you know, 100% scary, ruthless, relentless horror mm-hmm. movies, but then they're also just, you know, they're classic films, you know, for everyone. This is something that, you know, you can, you know, it's a group experience. And,
And this, obviously, I know none of y'all are involved in the marketing, but, like, it's not being marketed as that. Like, I feel like y'all are trying to hide it, and I, out of curiosity, if you don't know, it's totally fine, but why?
I think it's the mystery. I think that, you know, there's so, you know, one of the things that, you know, the guys at New Line have said is, you know, it's so rare. I mean, people are already catching on, and I think by the time the movie comes out, then everybody
I think the reviews are spoiling it already.
Yeah, I mean, basically, it's like people will know. But I think that, you know, the idea and the hope is that, you know, secrets in movies are, you know, there are so few and far between, and I think that we can usually guess the ending of mm-hmm. most movies, or, you know, guess who dies in these major franchises or who doesn't. And so to be able to have this connection, which everybody loves, I think that was really fun, mm-hmm. and, you know, just that sense of discovery.
As I was walking in, y'all were talking about the Scooby-Doo stuff. I love you in Scooby-Doo.
Thank you. Was
that intentional, that gag in there, to have Scooby-Doo playing on the TV?
Yeah, that was there's a Linda suggestion. You know, of course, when we're filming...
And Michael Clear, too. Michael, one of the producers, too. So, yeah. We were, like, laughing about it, and they're like, oh, we actually did that. So...
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Well, and so, the two of you have background in horror films. I remember being 10 years old seeing you in The Mummy, and it's like, you're forever ingrained in my brain for that. You were done From Dusk Till Dawn 2?
2, yeah. With Scott Spiegel, yeah.
Yes! Yeah. And then, honestly, I feel like your only horror that you've done, loosely, is the Scooby-Doo movies.
I think in the very, very beginning of my career, I did like a small part in a mm-hmm. movie. But never like this, no. And so that's part of the reason
why. What? You said this was your first horror movie.
No, I was the first part like this in a horror. Like, well, I was just starting my career. I wasn't the main person. Like, I didn't have that much to do. I sort of just didn't do it for a mm-hmm. while, you know. And when this came up, I thought, wow, what a great character. She stands on her own. She's a single mom. There's other females that are at the head of. You know, there's a lot mm-hmm. of females in this movie, which I love about horror films.
Oh yeah,
she's strong.
And of course, Ray.
Who's the comic relief? Yeah. Very effective comic
yes,
relief.
Yes, absolutely.
Oh, you're giving it away.
it'll be when it comes out.
Oh, when it comes out. Yes, I'm very funny.
But I hadn't done anything like it. So mm-hmm. that was something that was really exciting to me. And I had come off of Daddy's Home. And I think I went on to do, you know, Green Book and a dark comedy for Netflix. So it's just, it was so different from everything I was doing. And we have talked about how horror really gets people to the movie theaters,
yeah.
and it becomes an experience mm-hmm. that people like to have. And so I thought I would love to explore doing something like that.
Well, the screening last night, I mean, like, you can, like, that vibe you get from an audience as you're watching it. I mean, we're all in the theater
yeah.
watching
yeah.
it.
Yeah, totally.
It's such a fun communal experience, and that's why I've always gravitated towards horror. So I'm glad. I'm glad that you are into that. And please, do more horror movies.
I would love to write more about you. Thank you. They're great parts for women in horror mm-hmm. movies,
yeah.
you know? Like, you really get to hold your own ground. And do your own thing, and in this movie, you know, even Llorona, she has her
yeah.
own arc.
You
know, she's
her.
not just mm-hmm. your she's yeah. not just your typical monster. You
no.
get to sort of understand her and Patricia, like, do you think everybody's one thing and there's something else? And even you, you're not sure whether you can trust you or not.
Yeah.
Right. I feel like you have that in life, too.
Yes.
Well, I'm getting the wrap-up cue. So I guess I'll just do, like, just a fun little, like, question here. Tell me your favorite horror movies.
The Shining.
Okay. That was really quick.
I love it.
Exorcist.
Nightmare on Elm Street.
Okay, I'll go for that. I'll go for it.
That's the fourth one.
What is yours?
The fourth one.
Scooby-Doo.
I'm showing my age. I Scream 2.
Oh.
2. It's
more than the first one? Scream 2 is good.
The first one's more important
in
terms of what it did for reviving a very dead genre in the 90s, but I think that 2 is the better film. And this will be on camera that I'm posting on my website, so I'm going to get shit for it. But go back and rewatch it. It's very, very good.
Yeah.
Okay. We'll do it.
Yeah.
Anyway, well, thank you all so much.
Thank
I really appreciate it.